So I just finished training. Happy to report that it went really, really well. It's my birthday, 43 today. Sometimes I feel 25, sometimes I feel 105. It really just depends on what my sciatic is deciding to do. But today went really, really well. I did 4x10 straight across sets on bench with 67.5 kilos. Happy to report the last set was as fast and as easy as the first set, so that's always a bonus. And then all my supersets, I went up in weight on everything, so that's always good. The only thing I didn't go up on was my tricep pushdowns, because I do them off of my lat pulldown machine and I can only jump in 10 pound increments. So I just added 2 additional reps onto each set on those since I couldn't go up in weight. Aside from that, it was a really good day. Finished in about 45 minutes, so that's always a bonus. And if there's anything that I can say, piece of advice I can give to you guys since I'm older and wiser right now, is to take care of your body because you only get one. So move, stay active, take care of yourself because it truly is the fountain of youth. And as you get older, there's nothing better than just being able to move and just do the simple things in life like tie your shoes, get up and down from a chair. So stay active.
I'm lying in the midnight hour, holding you just like a dream. Love is never what it seems. When you turn and you're...
Training is done. Went really well today, despite the heat. Look who's here. I love him. And also managed to get all of my 5 sets of the hardest superset ever, which is single arm lat pull downs with chin ups. Did all 5, all full range of motion, and did some extra stuff. Check it out. So decided to get out early. It's 7:30, gonna get my squat training done because it is so hot. And I don't know about you guys, but if you train in your garage and you wait too long, even if you have a fan, all it does is just blow hot air in your face. And for whatever reason, I'm fine like doing upper body stuff on a hot day, but when I have to squat, if it's really hot, I get super dizzy and I feel like I'm gonna pass out. So I just jumped in the shower. My hair is wet, so I'm not sweating this much yet. I'm gonna get it done, and straight across sets today, 92.5 on high bar squats for sets of 10. So I'll probably just still have wet hair by the end of it because it'll just be filled with sweat. So see how it goes.
You see this?
Today is done. It took about 1 hour, 25 minutes. Make sure when you're inputting your fatigue, there's lots of things that can affect your fatigue, like the heat, for instance. So I had to adjust my fatigue rating because it's really hot and I don't anticipate it getting any cooler. This way, like next week, I don't nearly pass out. But got it done. It's lower days are always just really, really hard, but you can get through it. You just gotta take extended rest periods if you have to, adjust your fatigue rating, account for things like heat, lack of sleep, heat. Did I say heat? Because it's hot as bowels out here. Anyways, was a good session and looking forward to a day off tomorrow and then hitting it hard on Friday and Saturday because I have a top set of deads on Saturday. So just looking forward to the day off. That's what I'm looking forward to. A day off and a nice cold tea with lots of ice. Another day, another pec pop. It's not how you do it. I don't know why, but like I'm no Jen Thompson. One day I'll be able to do the pec popping, but got through it. It's hot as balls in my garage today. I'm sweating and I'm not like a sweater, but today was hot. And on upper days, I'm totally okay getting it done in the heat. I actually don't get sick from it. Lower days is going to be dreadful when it's hot. Tomorrow I have heavy deadlifts, so I'm looking forward to that. I have a top set of 8 tomorrow Any guesses on what I'll try to go up to? I'm supposed to have, I believe, zero reps in reserve, so we'll see how I feel when warm-ups go, but definitely gonna try to get in here and get that done super early tomorrow, because if it's as hot as it is today, there's no way that, I don't know, I'll just die. I cannot, me and heat don't mix. I need to do something in my garage. So aside from that, good workout. Gym mascot is here today. Am I wearing my socks? Conejito, Ben. Session, another hour and 30 minute lower body session, which I'm just assuming now is just going to be the norm with these sessions because it is just so hard. Make sure, so today I had a top set of deads followed by back down sets. So as soon as I did my top set and it was zero reps in reserve, I adjusted my fatigue rating to 5 so that it would lower my drop sets significantly. So make sure when you're in the system and you're feeling tired, make sure that you go ahead and you adjust your fatigue rating, because if you don't, those drop sets are gonna be at a higher weight and it's gonna feel like trash. So as soon as you finish your top set on those days, if you're feeling exhausted after that top set, which usually I am, because I feel like once you do the top set, you've kind of already, you know, done your thing, and then mentally you're like, okay, I'm done, I did my top set. So I went ahead and I adjusted my fatigue rating after I did my top set to a 5, which is the highest fatigue rating in the system, and that dropped my my drop sets significantly. So my top set was at 150 kilos, 330 pounds, fatigue rating went to a 5, and then that made my drop sets go down to 120 kilos, which made it a 10 times more manageable versus leaving it a 2, which is what the system defaults to, which is a 2 level fatigue rating. So make sure that you're doing that in the system. Aside from that, good session. Got it done early so it wasn't so hot, and excited to have a day off tomorrow. Also excited to getting my house painted today on the inside. So I'm excited to see how that turns out. And I hope that you guys are having a great Saturday. And if you are interested in power building, don't forget to swipe up.